I have discovered that a lifetime of traveling in primitive regions, a lifetime of seeing people living in the wilderness and using it, that there is a hard core wilderness need in everyone, a core that makes its spiritual values a basic human necessity. There is no hiding it, unless we can preserve places where the endless spiritual needs of man can be fulfilled and nourished. Will destroy our culture and ourselves.
Thank you. A great many people, young people, come to see me. And they ask me, what is your hope for the world? And I always answer them that the hope for the world is in you. You are the new generation. I'm the old generation. It's just like this little tree here. This is a sapling. Right beside it is one of these enormous red pines. This sapling epitomizes you and the hope of the world. So, when you wonder how things are going, just remember that. You have your task to do. You've got to carry on the battle to preserve such beautiful places as this. The battle goes on endlessly. It's your task. You've got to see that you keep the flame alive, no matter what the obstacles. The whole world depends on you. The whole world depends on this little pine, in a sense, just as at one time it depended on these enormous trees here.
final snow has fallen. North wind fell silent. Rushing waters awaken. Yet the woods are lumbering ghosts in the valleys haunt the birch speckled hills. And the north awakens from winter's chill. How many more glorious winters will we survive? There may only be few. Perhaps we'll never know. The answer will haunt us. So ask the moss beneath the snow. Perhaps we'll never know. But the answer will haunt us. Past the moss beneath the snow.
Well, it came from far off, over behind the hills, and he was raised on the silent stars and the sounds of the whippoorwill. Now he's drifting slowly, in search of hope and wealth, traded in poverty and scenery for money and hell. He's just a young man, still in his prime, now faceless cog in some old factory line. He's got a 40 wallet, and he's far from home. They ain't drink whiskey, but he'll drink alone. The years pass by, as they often do. And autumn's grays, and winter's blues. His memories fade, and the pastel hues. Mountains and hollers that his childhood knew. He died cold one night in a cinder block room. Some say that his heart just quit. Beneath the concrete and steel and the city lights before the first frost. But I knew that that wasn't it. Thank you. last breath, those twilight moments of existence. He died from a broken heart, from no mountains in the distance. It's true, it was the vile hum of grinding gears and the oppressive weight of concrete and steel. The war down his soul until it was flat, and then it crushed his heart through a broken back. And they buried him there in a stranger's grave, with his proud mountain so far away. The factories closed and the buildings burned, and they left all his things out on the curb. And sometimes you'll see him on a darkened road, his lonely ghost wandering home.
distance between nightmares and dreams. And the difference between knowledge and belief. For these long games I've been trapped. Just a glimmer, and that's all. Dreams are nothing more than sleep. Find higher bricks after you've climbed. There is a difference between knowledge and belief. Hope's just a glimmer, and that's all. Dreams are nothing more. Find higher bricks after you climb these walls. There is a difference between knowledge and thank you. valleys once galloped in. Now thick as he has been wounds. Winter was short and abnormally dry. Snowfall had been so slight. The sun had set and the journey she made under the northern lights. The cabin wasn't far from her, so she followed the guide of the stars. Thought had been early, but not a stitch of green.
When I'm gone, keep on turning. Thank you.
get the call. December, when the winter wind blows, screeches and screams, with the wind of the snow.
Gonna fix all the problems, light in your friends' pockets, for new jobs and a stronger economy. Bring back American jobs from distant foreign shores, when for years you sent them off overseas. Stop the conservative agenda, attack your criticisms with rhetoric as blunt as it can be. Issue license to anyone for acting like an asshole. Credence to every bigot in this country. Arguments are flimsy, logic paper thin, exactly like your skin seems to be. Closing off the border, rapid fire executive orders, implement your immigration policy. It's time to take responsibility instead of passing blame for the heritage of shit that we pass on. Take a deep look in the mirror and stop trying to make fine art from the lines in the sand that we've drawn. Things crystal clear, I certainly don't blame you, and I don't give a damn who lives in that house. You are just a symptom of an inherited disease. You can't always blame the itch on the lounge. I could use the sun. And at times you grant my request just before the rain. Ambivalent spite of stone. Reason to you.
power of mountain piles. He strode aside the oil sheen vest, woodland lake shores, where songless birds lay rotting, silent forevermore. Ladled fields and decaying stumps, he smiled at his work. And when he'd gloated long enough, he made a left-hand turn. Inside, kicked off his boots, all muddied on the floor. He passed the mirror.